Hey, what's up, everybody? Welcome back to Rodney and Jonelle. I hope you guys are having a great, great, great day. Hope all is well with you. Hope you guys are staying safe. Hope you're keeping your family safe. So today we're just going to fry some whiting and some whatever else we're going to cook. I don't know. I don't want to tell you no lie. So you guys stay tuned, and we are going to do this fish. So we got the grease hot already. This is a little piece of whiting right here. Look at some. It's so nice. So we just got some regular cornmeal. A fish fry batter, whatever this is here. I did not mean to make a big mess. But let Nell tell you.
What? Let me tell you what. Don't put me in your mess.
Right. Look out there.
That's all I know.
The 10 minutes up, babe. I found free music that we can play. It's on my YouTube, so you can play free music in the background, because when I start making money, I ain't got no money to pay anybody for their music. No, that don't mean I don't like their music, because I like it. But I won't be paying for it like that. But don't get me wrong. I don't want to take no coins off your car, no kernels off your car. All right, guys, so pretty much I'm just flipping that fish out. Man, you know what we should have made? We should have made hush puppies.
Yeah.
Now, I want to send a shout out to the like mom, like daughter.
Yeah. That was so, so wonderful today.
You guys really touched my heart today.
Yeah.
I love to see teamwork. I love to see you guys working together. You did a great job, man. Little one, you keep up, keep reading, keep studying. Keep paying attention, learn all you can. Be like a sponge. Learn everything. Learn everything. And then to your mom, you keep encouraging her to be the best you can be. Because this is your star.
And you be the best you can be too.
And you be the best you can be too, because I know you are.
You got a whole lot of life to you, homie.
That's right. When you get old. Now listen, now I know you said, what she said? Young man. So let me tell you how old I am, so then you can put me in records. So I'm 43. I think I'm old some days because I'll be in pain. And then some days I feel good like I'm young dude. But never do I put it in my mind that I'm a young man no more. When I was young, I did dumb, stupid stuff. Now that doesn't apply to everybody. Some people are young and they make good decisions. There's people my age who was young who made good decisions. I was just a dumb person, a number two. That's what I call myself. I had to learn the hard way. You know, what I mean by that, so number one, it's a number one, and number two, and number three. Now, number one, they can see something happen and see somebody going through it. They learn on the first go-round, they don't have to go through it no more. Now, number two, which is me, I go through it a couple times and watch other people go through it, and I still bump my head, but I get it right. Then it's a number three. They keep going through it, then they see people go through it, and they just never learn. They just never get it. So that's why I sell them number two. Anyway, let's see what this fish doing over here. It's looking good. So I'm thinking about making me a fish sandwich. Look at baby. Okay, well, you need to move it out my way because he's in the way.
Okay.
And please hurry every chance you get.
Okay.
I'll mess with you.
No, you for real, you for real.
No, I ain't for real. I'm for messing with you.
Mm-hmm.
For real. All right, so look, doesn't that fish look good right there? So, now, I know y'all see all this right here. And I ain't had this all before when I was younger.
You don't have to
have
it all on camera, right?
Yes, I do. Look at that refrigerator. So I'm going to lose this.
Right now,
when I look down, I can't even see right there where my toenails meet my feet at. When I was young, I could see my whole ankle. Now I look down, I can't see nothing. Don't cut it out, it's the truth. It's the truth. Yeah.
I don't know.
Like Dr. Now say, when he told the dude was over there, he told me he didn't want to be mild nourished. Dr. Now said, dude, you don't look mild nourished to me.
I don't know.
What do you mean you don't know? And yeah. You think that you're not eating and you're getting
I don't want to get malnourished either.
Do you look like you are malnourished?
Okay, so that's the fish. Alright guys, so we're finally at this stage where we're gonna just build sandwiches. And here we are. So we have, hey, you made some tartar sauce, right?
I mean,
well, you made
you
tartar
call it tartar sauce.
So look, when I taste it, so it brought back, I had like memories. So I don't know what this is. She got
it's mayonnaise. Bread and butter pickles, a little bit of the bread and butter pickle juice, some lemon juice, some pepper, and some Cavenders.
So I'm going to take that and spread that on here. And then I'm just going to do this. I'm just going to put tomatoes on there. Come here now. Put some tomatoes on there. And a few onions. Stay right there. Stay right there. Take some black pepper. We're going to do this other side. You're going to have to make some more of this. Because whatever you made here was really, really good. Mm-hmm. So I'm not putting no meat on it, guys.
No meat on what?
On the sandwich right here. I'm just going old school right here. Cause
I thought we was making fish sandwiches.
We are making fish sandwiches. But with this fish sandwich, we're going to make an old-fashioned tomato and mayonnaise sandwich real quick. Just for the hell of it. Now, do you want a piece? Because I'm going to try a piece.
Go ahead.
Okay. Mmm. Tastes like grandma house. Mmm. For those of you who remember, we made tomato and mayonnaise sandwiches. Not by choice, but by force. Because you wish you had some meat on there, but you're too broke. Now, some people eat it because they got the money to do it. I'm gonna eat this because we have nothing but this. So, you just up and record me. I wasn't even ready.
Okay. I'm not ready either. That's why I said no. Sandwich.
Mm-hmm. You ain't ready.
Okay. Whatever. Okay.
We're gonna keep building the sandwiches. So, we got fish over here ready. Ready to go. So, I don't know if y'all ever been to a nightclub before. I've been somewhere where you can order fish sandwich. So I'm gonna put some of Nell's special sauce on here.
I'm supposed to make some more.
You're supposed to. But she's so busy over there doing YouTube.
Or doing you, boo.
Aw, that's so sweet.
Maters.
Yeah, let's put that there. Fish.
I think I want an onion on mine. You put lettuce and everything?
Yeah. You want lettuce on yours, right?
Uh-huh.
You want a little cocktail sauce?
Sure, why not?
Do you have a dry sandwich?
Yeah, who likes dry sandwiches? And I know. Alright.
So that's the sandwich, guys.
Yay.
Did you want a pickle? Did you want a pickle on there?
Mm-hmm. Good.
So let's close them up. You want me to cut them here?
No.
Okay, that's yours. Let me write. Oh, no. Please. I don't know.
Great.
Venomous.
Yay.
Okay. Now mine's is next. Where the bread at? Y'all. We finally here where we can sit down and eat, guys. So, we made fish. We made white. Why y'all up on me? But anyway, we're about to try to fish up, guys.
We did have great day and all that stuff?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. So this is a fish that we fried.
Pretty good.
Yeah, but I can't help it sometimes. I'm slow.
You did that.
Fish sandwich.
So, after this, we probably could walk and get somebody to go walk with me. I'm using the hot sauce.
Mm-hmm. Whoa. That's good.
It's really tasty. I didn't get this belly, and I know how to cook, guys.
So how y'all doing today? How's everybody? I hope life's good.
Hope y'all staying safe.
Yeah, stay safe. We say that in every video. Stay safe. That is a must.
I really mean it.
Yeah.
You know, when I say it, I think about it. Like, I got a wife and kid. I want you to go home to your wife and kid too.
Right.
I want you to go home to your spouse and kid too. So, and then I want them to be safe as well. So I really mean that from the bottom of my heart. Because I don't want nobody to be hurting or lose nobody because of this coronavirus.
For any reason other than like natural causes. Anything other than that, it's a no-go.
Look good, guys.
The bread stick to the roof of your mouth though.
You like a ham sandwich?
Mm-hmm.
That's good.
Yeah. They keep you from being able to talk. And like, I don't want to talk about muscles. That's not cute.
So look, I'm happy. School's over with. Our son, he passed.
We're in high school. Whoa.
Going to high school.
Whoa.
We got
talk about getting old.
Right, we got this is our baby boy going to the ninth grade.
A baby boy going to high school.
Right.
Whoa! Can't wait for him to graduate.
The other two are 20.
1 and 22. Well, he was about to be 22 in August.
Yeah, 21 and 22. So we actually, I'm 43.
And I refuse to dive over to my age. It's none of ya.
She's 29.
Mm-mm. But I ain't telling. You know how when you're a little kid and you get something good to eat? And you run up to the table and take a bite and dance away. And then come back and get another bite for the answer.
Let it happen in my time. You better sit your butt down.
Yes, I understand.
You better sit your butt down. Let it get the
I mean, okay. My kids were allowed to do that. I was not allowed to do that. Let me clarify. Because we need to eat. You sit at the table and you don't talk, you don't do nothing until you eat all that food.
Right.
And you don't play at the table. That's what we told
them. Right, so that's the we don't.
You sit down and eat.
We don't force it on that kid at all.
Yeah. That was torture. You know how they say, you know, you should sit down and have dinner with your family to talk and, you know, and like bond and shit. I mean, stuff. No, it was not bonding. It was you sit down, you eat, and then
get out of here. This is so good, man.
Whitening like lightning?
Yeah, whitening like lightning. This is good stuff, ma'am.
Yeah. Okay, cool.
So,
we're slowing down.
So, look, I hope the country opens back up, man. I hope everybody in America and across the world, things pick up for you and life starts to prosper, man, because it's rough out here. It's scary not knowing.
I mean, it's scary for a lot of reasons. It's scary for a lot of reasons, but, I mean, can't walk around afraid. You still gotta live your life.
Right, so.
And try your best to be happy.
You know, reply. I woke up this morning. The first thing I see is, because I did apply for the SBA. So I did, SBA I applied for. So they declined me. And my heart is broken. My heart is broken. I'm like, why y'all decline me? I said, I don't have enough credit. I don't have enough for our credit built up. So, that broke my heart that I couldn't do that. And then I see people getting millions of dollars and they commit fraud. And then they say, oh, we caught this person. They got $1.4 million in fraud. Still in my friend, I need that money. I'm gonna put the money back in the community. If I get enough money to where we can make enough soap and get enough jobs on the side where I can hire people, then I'm gonna hire somebody to work for me. And then we're going to continue doing jobs and the money go back in the community. I know when I was younger, people used to say this, and I'm getting out of subject, where they used to complain about Hispanic people working. And I used to work in Texas, and they would take the money. As soon as they make it, they send it right back to the country. So the money don't stay in the country, and it don't circulate within our system. Well, I used to work at a Chinese restaurant. And I seen like one dude on all of them. And they every night, after they get through making the money, they take it and go straight to Western Union. And Western Union, the money, straight to China. The Chinese restaurants. So they didn't keep the money. The money don't stay in the U.S. It don't stay in our economy. I don't know. I know one thing. It ain't good for our economy. Anyway, I'm just it broke my heart today, so I might try to redo the reconsideration that they're talking about. But it's like, why? You know, I've been so used to struggling all my life. We've been struggling this whole time and still making it. I hate to say this, but it's like, this is another skill that we learned growing up, is how to struggle. How to make it through the hard time. I remember being in the war, and my friends would tell me, damn, Rodney, you look like a poor man king. I know how to pull my resources together and make stuff work for me. So during the meantime, I can make it until times get better, if that makes any sense to you guys. So it's the same thing now. These people, they denied me a loan. They denied me stuff, the opportunity, because I need that money. I really need that money to do stuff for our business. But it's okay. I'm not going to cry. I'm not going to complain. As they say, now they tell us to pull ourselves up by the bootstraps. That's exactly what I got to do. I got to pull ourselves up by our bootstraps. And we got to just keep paying out of pocket and just keeping our business afloat and keep finding jobs and keep doing what we can do. Because as of right now, we don't qualify for any kind of loans or anything through the SBA. And that hurts. We're American. We qualify to pay the taxes every year on the money we make. I'll tell you that. And we do have to pay that every year. And I'm not complaining. I don't mind paying my taxes, but I need help. And they're not helping us. So, anyway, but that's not here or there, because we, like I said, we are used to struggling. We're used to surviving. I know that's not something to brag about. But I'm very glad. Like I said, I've been made a man for all the mistakes I made. And the experiences that I've made have also made me a man. So this is my first rodeo of going through bullshit. I mean, we're going to ride this out. We're going to make it, and we are going to succeed. So I want you guys to do the same thing. I want you to stay positive. It's rough on everybody. Don't think because I've been eating all this good food and stuff, it ain't hard. We hustle to make this change. And I go to the grocery store and pick this stuff. You guys have been to the grocery store with me. I don't pick $7, $8 meat. I do adulting. I go in there for $7, I can get 5 trays of meat because I'm getting chicken legs, if that's what it is. So I do what I have to do until I can do better for my kids. So I'm not content where I'm at, but I can contend where I'm at until it's time to, if that makes sense. I can stay where I'm at and maintain where I'm at until another opportunity presents itself. So I wish you guys the best. You got something to say? I truly love you guys. I wish you guys the best. Thank you for coming through. Subscribe to our channel. Please don't forget to hit that like button, hit that subscribe, and hit that bell so you get notifications of when the next time we're making videos. And also, I want to send a shout out to the Like Mom and Like Daughter. You guys are awesome, and I wish you guys the best. I wish that to see you guys on Ellen talking about how cute you are. And that's what my wishes are for you guys. So, until next time, guys, eat something good.